residents of Corazon de Jesus. There was a lot of throwing of stones at each other, which eventually made the residents retreat. So they have actually retreated a couple of feet back. And right now, again, it's a standoff. It wasn't as ugly as it was. Mm-hmm. What you're seeing right now isn't as ugly as it was a while back. But yeah, that is the common scene, except a lot of stones were being thrown a while ago. And palapit na ng palapit yung members of the demolition team and the police. And at some point, lumalayo na, nagre-retreat na yung supposedly the residents. But again, this is live footage over there in Barangay Corazon de Jesus over in San Juan, where the demolition team is hoping that the residents would finally leave the area and go to the housing units that is provided to them over in Montalban for about 100 families. And soon enough, 3 to 4 years after, they will be relocated back to San Juan around the area of the where the city hall is being built in the Paglabanan Church.
Nabalita sa atin kanina din ni Jackie Manabat Pinky that there are two entrances to that area where the demolition should be ongoing. And Jackie is reporting that both entrances have been secured by the demolition team. So we might have a situation here na medyo na corner na yung mga residente. Pero nakikita pa rin natin na hindi pa rin sumusugod itong demolition team at mga police. Siyempre, dahil binabato pa rin ng mga residente ng Barangay Corazon de Jesus. But we're seeing more of them right now than the video we saw earlier.
I guess maximum tolerance is still being implemented by members of the demolition team. But, you know, this is a site that isn't new to us. This is something that we've seen, well, time and time again. But it's probably going to take a while. They are, again, implementing maximum tolerance and trying to get nearer and nearer to the site of that particular site in Barangay Corazon de Jesus over there in San Juan. Fire truck, right? That's a fire truck being also reversing on its way closer to the members or to the residents over there in San Juan.
We had a report from DZMM, or you saw it on screen a while ago, that at least 4 people have been injured. No identification yet if there are residents or part of the demolition team.
Well, we can only hope that no injuries will be sustained, at least no major injuries will be sustained by any member of any resident or any member of the demolition team or even members of the police. So I guess you have the members of the police demolition team just implementing an order, and of course you have residents saying, no way, you're not going to take our homes away from us. There you go. I guess that must be coming from the... Well, that's the Bureau of Fire and Protection, the BFP over there.
Just a quick background there again, Pinky. The notice of demolition was issued to them. That was issued to them expired last January 5th, and it was reported that they've been given 3 warnings already to leave the area. But mukhang pinagandaan talaga ng mga residente and even the local government, because Jackie Manabat reported also that schools have been suspended. Schools in that area around the demolition area have already been suspended even before the demolition began.
Well, we have our teams there monitoring the situation.